what were you reading on the way here?
I was reading, actually I can bring it out. It would actually be good to bring it out because it's been so heavy, but completely worth it.
What is it? Like a giant...
It's a giant tome.
It's a giant... It's the longest book that's ever been written.
I refuse to read on Kindles or anything because I just like the tactile experience of reading an actual book. So that's why I've got this slightly unglamorous bag. It's basically a
just
book,
for the book
bag.
Here's my giant suitcase that I keep my book in.
Do I have anything else in it?
Tell me about it. Okay. Oh, signed first edition.
Yes. So this is a Fallout by Tim Shipman, who's an amazing political journalist. He's the political editor of the Sunday Times, and it's all about the lead up to the shambolic general election of 2017.
Isn't it incredibly stressful to read, though?
It's because it's so thrilling. I don't know what it is about the way he writes. It's incredibly gripping. He's a very good reporter.
Right.
He's got incredible access. He's interviewed kind of hundreds and hundreds of people, so you really feel like you have a ringside seat to the shambles that was Theresa May's election campaign.
Because it's all like, a member texted so-and-so.
Exactly.
Right. So did you whiz through it?
Well, I'm whizzing through it.
Yeah.
I'm still here, but it is genuinely one of those ones I don't really want to end,
even though
it is again going to end badly. And it's a tricky also thing to read in the bath, because it's quite heavy on one's wrist.
I also looked up the best-selling books of the week.
Yes.
Which are... Fire and Fury,
yes.
Joe Wicks, the body coach.
He talks about broccoli as like miniature trees.
Does he?
Yeah.
As though one's talking to a small child. And then a Lee Child. Have you ever read any Lee
never
Childs?
Never.
No, nor
read
have
Lee
I.
Childs. No.
I want to, though.
I've actually never read John Grisham either. And that's not because I'm being pompous about it. I've just never got around
to it. So tell me about when you're starting a new novel, what that looks like for you.
Oh my God, it looks like a really untidy, yeah. It looks like a really untidy and unstable bird's nest in the focal point of my brain. So what does it look like? I basically have to allow myself to have an idea.
Mm-hmm.
And I found in the past that if I go out in search of that idea, it's a bit like sort of hunting for the Gruffalo, you won't ever find it.
Right.
Or you'll come up with an idea that you try and persuade yourself to write and it doesn't work organically. And generally my ideas come from a mixture of things, but in the past they've often been prompted by something I've read in the newspapers or something I've done in my job as a journalist. So with The Party, my most recent one, I actually started doing that thing of writing the idea that I thought I was meant to have.
Right.
Which was about Northern Ireland in the 1990s, where I grew up.
Right.
And I just got to a point where I felt I was winching every sentence up from a great subterranean depth. And just like, because I was splattering it onto the screen. And I just thought, actually, why am I doing this? Because I'm not enjoying it and I don't think it's any good. And I'm just going to put it to one side and write about something incredibly glamorous and fun about rich people having a party. And that was genuinely the starting point for that.
And do you sit at your desk at your computer and tappity-tap away?
So generally I will do my journalism, I'll get up early and I'll meet that deadline, and then I take my laptop and I go and sit in a cafe because I quite like being around the murmur of other people.
And I suppose out in the world.
Yes, otherwise I'd never talk to anyone. Otherwise I'd never get any inspiration ever.
Yeah.
I'd just be on my own in my pyjamas.
I haven't spoken to anyone for days. I have no idea. Well, how do people talk again? What is dialogue?
I've drunk 85 cups of green tea and I'm feeling really wired.
Now can we talk about your date tonight?
Oh my God.
Okay, we'll stop filming for this. We'll talk more about books next time. Okay, tell me all.